been struggling with this cross tutorial, and this is my second time recording this because my webcam that I was using, it was not like recording it. It was just like showing me record it, but wasn't actually making any recordings. So I got my camera, forged for batteries, and I'm here. Let's start this thing. Okay, so I'm gonna make a shirt that's similar to this. I don't know if you guys can see me. Well, you can hear me. That's all that matters. Similar to this, it's gonna be thicker. I already have it pretty much set up. I just need to start painting, but I will show you guys what you need. Paper bag to put in between the shirt. Paper plate to put the paint in. Painter's tape to outline the cross so you can paint it in, it'll make it clean. I use painter's tape because when you remove it, it makes a clean line and it doesn't bleed through. And I put the paper bag in between the shirt so that it not bleed through to the other side. I also used an old shirt that my dad gave me. It doesn't matter what color. Obviously, I used red on the last one. This one is navy blue, but you all see that it has holes in it. It's grungy looking, so I really like it. So we've got like a million napkins for cleaning off the brush. Some water. This water is old because I did it earlier, obviously. I got flat paintbrush, Crayola. It came in a pack of like five or six, and it was like $5 or $6. Nothing fancy. Slanted Crayola paintbrush and two foam brushes. These were like 49 cents at Michael's, like literally, and I got them really little, so it'll be easier to work with. And on to the paint. White. This was like $1.99. It's like the cheap stuff at Michael's. Gray, on sale for 29 cents. Michael's as well. Black on sale for 29 cents. Sailing Sky on sale for 29 cents. Plum, 29 cents. Bright Magenta, also 29 cents. Denim, also 29 cents. Silver Glitter Paint, $1.19. Purple, 29 cents. Pink, 29 cents. I think I showed you that already, but I'm not sure. Let's get paint. Okay, this is what we're working with. I already outlined the cross duct tape, made it thick. It's kind of off center, which I kind of wanted that effect. The paper is already in between. Make sure when you're sticking it on there that it gets as flat as you can get it. Right here is a little weird, but that's no big deal. But get it as flat as you can get it, and here we go. As you all can see here, I'm just outlining the tape with the black paint with my foam brush. I'm just outlining it so you can get it on the tape. Just make sure you do not go over onto the other side of the tape, and make sure you add a lot,
even stretching the fabric, making sure that you get all the crevices that were bent up. You keep doing that until you're completely done.
Okay, here's my cross so far.
Now, you're going to let it dry. Make it sure the black is completely dry, because if the black isn't completely dry, when you add the other layers of paint, then it will just smudge and it will look like a big plop, glob, glip of like gray. This is where you show your creativity. You would take the foam, the little foam guy, and you will first add like a base of white, then over it a little bit of purple, over that a little bit of blue, kind of journaling along the cross, making sure that it's completely random. You're going to take your slanted or your flat brush, it doesn't matter which one, and you're going to dip it in your silver glitter paint. And you're going to add like little dots all across the thing, kind of like little stars.